BGMC. The biblical truth lives here.
The ancient Hebrew scriptures foretold of the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach. The Messiah Yeshua came to call the people back to the truth of His word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
Vamos a repasar las primeras dos partes.
Okay, and then next week we will start all new information.
Y la próxima semana comenzamos con nueva información.
Next week we'll be starting Matthew 5, verse 3.
La próxima semana vamos a comenzar con Mateo, capítulo 5, versículo 3.
But I think it would be good to review everything. We're on slide number 2.
Pienso que es buena idea repasar todo. Estamos en la página
so
número 2.
So welcome to the City Gate Bible Study Review.
So bienvenidos a repaso del estudio bíblico de la puerta de la ciudad.
Going on to the next slide.
En la próxima página.
Let's turn to Matthew 5, verse 48. That's our standard verse that we're going to be working with.
Vamos a Mateo capítulo 5, versículo 48. Ese va a ser el versículo principal de la cual vamos a estar mirando para estudiar.
Matthew 5, verse 48.
Mateo capítulo 5 versículo 48.
This is in the fourth class, right?
Pienso que esta es la cuarta clase, yes.
Yes. Like I said, this is a review because we just went through the holy days.
Como dije, esto es un repaso porque terminamos de pasar por los días santos.
And we gotta get our heads back into this study.
Y tenemos que regresar nuestras cabezas a este estudio.
Matthew 5, verse 48.
Mateo capítulo 5, versículo 48.
Therefore, be perfect just as your Father in heaven is perfect. Amen? That is the goal.
Ese es la meta.
Now, you know, a lot of people say that, no, you can't be perfect.
Mucha gente dicen, oh, no puede ser perfecto.
And I agree with that in some part.
Y estoy de acuerdo con eso por algunas partes.
Our object is to try our best.
Nuestro objetivo es hacer lo mejor posible.
Because there's a difference between open disobedience.
Porque hay una diferencia entre desobediencia abierta.
And errors that we make.
Y errores que cometemos.
Or stumbling that you do.
O que uno se cae.
Anybody ever miss that last step
on the stairs? Hay algunos de ustedes que no pisaron ese último escalón en las escaleras.
Okay, where you're like, whoa,
a donde parece que tropiezas y casi te cae.
That's a stumbling.
Eso es casi caerse.
Okay, so with the Lord, what Yeshua is saying here.
Lo que Yeshua estaba diciendo aquí.
He's saying strive for perfection.
Él está diciendo que luche para la perfección.
And we need to keep that in our understanding.
Y tenemos que mantener eso en nuestros entender.
Because everything in the study is going to lead up to that part.
Porque todo en este estudio nos va a llevar a esa parte.
Every verse that we study that Yeshua had said in this discourse.
Say that again.
Every word that we study in Yeshua's discourse.
Cada palabra que estudiamos en el discurso de Yeshua.
Is going towards this particular goal.
Nos lleva a esta meta en particular.
Okay. So turn back to Deuteronomy 19.
Regresemos a Deuteronomio capítulo 19.
Hold your place in Matthew.
Mantén su lugar en Mateo.
Because we're going to keep going back to that.
Porque vamos a seguir regresando a ese versículo.
Turn to Deuteronomy 19, verse 14. Ouch.
Oops. Vamos a Deuteronomio capítulo 19, versículo 14, por favor.
Deuteronomy 19, verse 14.
Deuteronomio 19, versículo 14.
Deuteronomy 19, verse 14.
Deuteronomio capítulo 19, versículo 14.
You are not to move your neighbor's boundary marker in the place where people put it long ago. An inheritance soon to be yours in the land Jehovah your Elohim is giving you to possess. Okay? If we go to our next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
The neighbor, we're looking at the part that says neighbor.
Estamos mirando la parte a donde dice vecino.
The word neighbor is rea or rey.
La palabra vecino es rea o rey.
Now remember, Yeshua calls us friend. He even called Judas friend.
Acuérdate que Yeshua nos llama amigos. Él llamó a Judas
so the
amigo.
The concept of this verse,
el concepto de este versículo,
is that there was a placement that God put a long time ago of his fence. There was a placement
of his fence.
Of his fence.
Que hubo un lugar a donde Jehová puso hace tiempo en su reja. En su reja.
And that he doesn't want moved.
Que no quiere que se mueva.
And the Jewish people, you know, moved it a lot by putting Talmud into the scripture.
Y el pueblo judío lo movió bastante poniendo el Talmud en las escrituras.
And the New Testament Christians totally destroyed the fence.
Y los cristianos del Nuevo Testamento destruyeron por total esa reja.
So if your friend set up his home,
so si tu amigo pone su casa,
and he put up a fence to where his property line would be,
y él pone una reja donde su línea de propiedad está,
would you really be a good neighbor if you moved his fence?
¿Serás buen vecino si mueves esa reja?
So that's why Yeshua said in Matthew 5, verse 48,
por eso que Yeshua dijo en Mateo 5, versículo 48,
be perfect. My marker is perfect.
Sea perfecto. Mi marcador es perfecto.
The other definition for the word rea,
la otra definición para la palabra rea,
is an intimate friend.
Es un amigo íntimo.
If you want to be close with somebody,
si quieres ser, estar cerca o cercano con alguien,
would you move their stuff?
Moverás las cosas de ellos.
So if you want to be a friend of God,
si quieres ser amigo de Dios,
is it nice to say, well, we don't need those kosher laws anymore?
Es bueno decir que ya no necesitamos esas leyes kosher.
So you move the boundary stone.
So tú mueves la piedra límite.
We don't need Pesach anymore.
Ya no necesitamos Pesach.
Then that's moving the boundary stone.
Entonces eso es moviendo la piedra límite.
Let's read verse 14 again.
Vamos a leer el versículo 14 de Deuteronomio capítulo
19. You're not to move your neighbor's boundary marker from the place where people put it long ago, an inheritance soon to be yours in a land Jehovah your Elohim is giving you to possess. Okay, so this is part of your inheritance.
Esto es parte de tu herencia.
So if you're moving that boundary mark,
so si estás moviendo esa piedra de límite,
you're losing some of your inheritance. And do you want to do that?
Estás perdiendo parte de tu herencia. ¿Quieres hacer eso?
Okay. And that answer is no.
Y la respuesta será no.
And the key here also is the underlying word long ago.
Y la clave aquí también es la palabra que está subrayada hace tiempo.
So something that's been established.
So algo que ha sido establecido.
Like God said, these are my ways I want you to live.
Como Dios dijo, estas son las maneras que yo quiero que vivas.
I put them there long ago.
Lo puse ahí hace tiempo.
Who are you? Why, if you're my friend, why are you moving them?
Si eres mi amigo, ¿por qué lo estás moviendo?
A friend would not move somebody else's stuff.
Un amigo no mueve las otras cosas que le pertenece a otro.
So that's really where you start this study.
Ahí es a donde comienzas este estudio.
God's word is perfect.
La palabra de Dios es perfecta.
He is the creator.
Él es el creador.
And he knows what's best for his children.
Él sabe que es mejor para sus hijos.
Sometimes you get a child that says, "Why don't we do it this way?"
A veces tienes un niño que dice, "¿Por qué no lo hacemos de esta manera?"
Anybody ever have that?
¿Han tenido eso antes?
You know, their children saying, "You know, we should do it this way, ma, dad."
Los niños diciendo, "Debemos de hacerlo de esta manera, ma, pa."
And you're like, "We've tried that before and it doesn't work."
Tú dices, "Hemos tratado eso antes y no
funciona." Maybe you just didn't do it right.
Tal vez no lo hiciste bien.
Okay, we've all been there as teenagers ourselves.
Hemos estado ahí como adolescentes nosotros mismos.
But this verse is very important for not just this study.
Pero este versículo es importante no solamente para este estudio,
but for following Yeshua.
Pero para seguir a Yeshua.
Don't move his boundary markers.
No muevas esa piedra de límite.
And what is his boundary markers?
¿Y cuál es su piedra de límite?
Shabbat. And the seven holy days.
Y los siete días santos.
And when you move those boundary markers,
y cuando mueves esa piedra de límite,
then you're not looking for perfection.
Entonces no estás buscando la perfección.
When you're not doing what the word says,
cuando no estás haciendo lo que la palabra dice,
you're not striving for perfection.
No estás luchando para la perfección.
And perfection is the Torah of God.
Y la perfección es la Torah de Dios.
And that's always, it's always very simple to know that.
Es bien simple saber eso.
And how do you know that?
¿Y cómo sabes eso?
In Matthew 5 verse 18 that we'll get to.
En Mateo 5 versículo 18 que llegaremos.
Yeshua says what?
Yeshua dice que,
until heaven and earth pass away,
hasta que el cielo y la tierra no pase,
not one jot or tittle will be missing from my Father's law. So if Yeshua says that in the middle of Matthew 5,
si Yeshua dice eso a mitad de Mateo 5,
then it's your job as his child,
entonces es tu trabajo
como su hijo, to strive for that perfection.
Para luchar para esa
perfección. And the way you strive for perfection,
y de la manera que luchas para esa perfección,
don't move the boundary stones.
No muevas la piedra de límite.
Okay, that was set up long ago.
Que fue puesta hace tiempo.
Any questions about this part?
Hay preguntas sobre esta parte.
It's, you know, it's pretty simple if you just listen.
Es bien simple si solamente escuchas.
But Yeshua said it's finished.
Pero Yeshua dijo se acabó.
Yes, your life if you move the boundary marker.
Sí, tu vida si mueves la piedra del límite.
Going on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
We look at the word boundary marker.
Miramos la palabra piedra del límite.
It is the Hebrew word gebul.
Es la palabra hebrea gebul.
When God said this is Naphtali's land.
Cuando Dios dijo esta tierra es de Naphtali.
This is Asher's land.
Esta tierra es de Asher.
People are not supposed to change that inheritance land.
La gente no está supuesto cambiar esa tierra de la herencia.
Okay, so it's the border.
So es la frontera.
It's the territory.
Es el territorio.
Okay, going on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Okay. This is the word for long ago in Hebrew.
La palabra para hace tiempo en hebreo
is rishon.
Es rishon.
Okay, that means first.
Significa primero.
Okay, the head.
La cabeza.
The primary part.
La parte primaria.
So you don't want to change the primary.
So no quieres cambiar lo primario.
Okay, that means like the law of first reference, the rishon.
Como la palabra, la ley de primera referencia, el rishon.
Once you get what the word means,
ya cuando entiendas lo que significa la palabra,
it doesn't change in the New Testament.
No cambia en el Nuevo Testamento.
Right? Words change outside of the Bible.
Las palabras cambian afuera de la Biblia.
And I always like to use a very, I like to give Paulian examples.
Y me gusta dar ejemplos de Pablo.
Okay. Words change in English.
Las palabras cambian en el inglés.
Now in the 1800s, the word fag.
En los 1800s, la palabra fag.
Meant a cigarette.
Significaba cigarrillo.
Or a little piece of cloth.
O un un pedazo de tela.
Now a fag means somebody from San Francisco.
Ahora fag significa alguien de San Francisco.
Who smokes a cigarette with a piece of cloth on.
Que fuma un cigarrillo con un pedazo de tela.
But when God said, Shema, listen.
Cuando Dios dijo, Shema, escuche,
it doesn't change in the New Testament.
No cambia en el Nuevo Testamento.
You know, salvation in the Old Testament is salvation in the New Testament.
La salvación en el Viejo Testamento es la salvación en el Nuevo Testamento.
Heaven in the Old Testament is still heaven in the New Testament.
El cielo en el Viejo Testamento todavía es el cielo en el Nuevo Testamento.
Shalom.
Shalom, shalom.
So here, Rishon.
So aquí, Rishon.
The first time it's used.
La primera vez que es usado.
Okay, when you're looking at this,
cuando estás mirando esto,
it's talking about the way things are done.
Está hablando sobre las maneras que las cosas son hechas.
Don't change it.
No lo cambies.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
We look at the word inheritance.
Miramos a la palabra herencia.
That is the Hebrew word nachala.
Es la palabra hebrea nachala.
Everybody want a big nachala when they die?
Todos quieren un gran nachala cuando mueren.
I want a big nachala.
Yo quiero un gran
nachala. Not a noogie, a nachala.
Not a noogie, pero nachala.
Okay. Nachala means your property.
Nachala significa tu propiedad.
Your possession.
Tu posesión. Tu posesión.
Need to do some push-ups or something? It needs your heritage.
Tu herencia. Tu sí, herencia.
Okay. So don't move that boundary stone.
No muevas esa piedra de límite.
Because when you do, you take away from your own nachala.
Porque cuando lo haces, quitas de tu propia nachala.
Okay. Let's move on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Okay, which just goes through those three words again.
Que repite esas tres palabras de nuevo.
And like I said, this is just review.
Como dije, esto es un repaso.
We'll slow it down in a little bit. If you have any questions.
Vamos a ir más despacio en un rato. Si tienes preguntas.
Just let me know.
Déjeme saber.
All right. Now, the next part of what we did a few weeks ago.
La próxima parte de lo que hicimos hace un par de semanas atrás.
Is we're connecting the dots.
Estamos conectando los puntos.
Okay, you ever get that coloring book for your children or your grandchildren?
¿Has comprado ese libro de colorear para tus hijos o tus?
Where you gotta go? Number one, you draw a line from 1 to 2 to 3.
A donde tú dibujas una raya del 1 al 2 al 3.
So we started out with Matthew 5 verse 48.
So comenzamos con Mateo capítulo 5 versículo 48.
Be perfect.
Seas perfecto.
For your Father in heaven is perfect.
Porque tu Padre en el cielo es perfecto.
Then we drew a line all the way back to Deuteronomy.
Entonces dibujamos una raya hasta Deuteronomio.
Where you're not to move your neighbor's boundary marker.
Que no debes de mover la piedra límite de tu vecino.
Where it was set up at first.
A donde estaba establecido primero.
Don't move it.
No lo muevas.
Now let's draw another line.
Ahora vamos a dibujar otra raya.
Turn to Hosea chapter 5 verse 10.
Vamos a Hosea capítulo 5 versículo 10.
Hosea 5 verse 10.
Hosea capítulo 5 versículo 10.
Go get the boy some coffee. Hosea 5, verse 10.
Hosea, capítulo 5, versículo 10.
Hosea 5.
Hosea, capítulo 5.
Verse 10.
Versículo 10.
The leaders of Yehuda are like men who move boundary stones. I will pour my fury out upon them like water. Okay? So when you move the boundary stone,
cuando mueves la piedra del límite,
you know, the fury might not be in this life.
La furia tal vez no se vea en esta vida.
In this particular account, it did happen.
En este cuento aquí, sí sucedió.
When God gets fed up, he kicks you out of the land.
Cuando Dios ya se cansa, él te echa fuera de la tierra.
And when he gets fed up,
Y cuando ese se cansa,
he allows his fury to happen to the world.
Él permite que su furia sea derramada al mundo entero.
And you should be ready for the fury that's going to happen.
Y debe de estar preparado para la furia que va a suceder.
The Russian armada landed in the Mediterranean Sea today.
El ejército ruso,
naval vessels.
Se plantó en el mar Mediterráneo.
Okay. So get ready for God to unleash his fury.
So, prepárate para Dios, derramar su furia.
So we must strive for perfection.
So debemos de luchar para la perfección.
Put the boundary marker back where it belongs.
Regresa la piedra de límite a donde pertenece.
Now you say, do I have to do it for other people?
De preguntas, ¿lo tengo que hacer para los demás?
No, you don't.
No lo tienes que hacer.
Because salvation is personal.
Porque la salvación es personal.
And you have a personal relationship with God himself.
Y tienes una relación personal con Dios mismo.
So he can pour out personal fury on you.
So él puede derramar furia personal sobre ti.
And if anybody's ever experienced bladder stones or something like that.
Si alguien ha experimentado piedras.
Or heart attack,
o un ataque del
corazón, or some sort of pain,
o algún clase de dolor.
That's God trying to get your attention.
Eso es Dios tratando de llamarte la atención. Thank you.
Yes, Adriana.
Thank you. Also, it means that I heard that sickness comes from sin, not all the sickness, but some sickness comes from sin. That means people that have moved that boundary story.
The question was about sickness. Does all sickness come from sin?
Sobre la enfermedad, ¿será que toda la enfermedad viene del pecado?
The answer is yes and no.
La respuesta es sí y no.
There are generational curses.
Hay maldiciones generacionales.
I know that the Christians don't like to hear that.
Yo sé que los cristianos no les gustan escuchar eso.
And some messianics don't like to hear that
y
either.
Y algunos mesiánicos tampoco.
But then God would have lied in the second commandment.
Entonces, Dios hubiera mentido en el segundo mandamiento.
You know, I'll put your sin on your children to the third and fourth generation.
Que pondré tu pecado en los hijos tuyos hasta la tercera y cuarta generación.
And my wife is a prime example.
Y mi esposa es un ejemplo.
She's got diabetes.
Ella tiene diabetes.
And you would think that while we're following Torah, God would heal her.
Tú pensarás que estamos siguiendo Torah.
Well, there
Dios
was
la sanará.
That woman called her grandmother.
La mujer, ella llamó a su abuela.
Who cursed the Jewish people.
Que maldijo al pueblo judío.
Now, salvation is personal.
Ahora, la salvación es personal.
So when she gets to heaven, she'll have a new body.
So cuando ella llegue al cielo, ella va a tener
she will no longer be married to me. She will be married to the Lord, who
ella
is a
no
good
va a estar
husband.
Casada conmigo. Ella va a estar casada con el Señor.
Okay, he's
buen
the perfect
esposo.
Husband.
Él es un esposo perfecto.
Yeah, he probably doesn't snore.
Y él tal vez no ronca.
Okay, all right. So, sickness, many times sickness is given by God. It says it in Deuteronomy.
Muchas veces la enfermedad es dada por Dios.
Okay.
Lo dice en Deuteronomio.
To get people's attention.
Para llamar la atención.
Sometimes the only way to get somebody's attention is to have them flat on their back.
Tal vez, a veces, para llamarle la atención a la gente, hay que, él deja que ellos estén estrechados en sus espaldas.
The only way to get David's attention,
la única manera de tomar la atención
in his one error,
en su error,
was to make his child sick and then to take the child's life.
Es que hacer su hijo enfermo, que se enferme su hijo y que le quite la vida.
We don't ever read about David doing that mistake again, do we?
Nunca leímos que David cometió ese mismo error.
A lot of people love to focus on that one error that he made. It was bad.
Mucha gente le gusta enfocarse en ese error que él cometió. Y fue malo.
We all make terrible mistakes.
Pero todito sí cometemos errores.
So don't hold it against David since he only did it once.
So no, don't hold it against David. No siga culpando a David por su error porque él solo lo hizo una vez.
Rabbi, it's like,
Yes.
That's it.
So the paraphrase of that was, Yeshua, after healing people, said, I see you're better.
La pregunta es que después que Yeshua sanó a la gente,
remember, he's in the temple.
Vi que estás mejor.
The guy who wanted to get into the water.
El hombre que quiso entrar al agua.
Now he says to the guy, go, don't go sin no more.
Y ahora le dice al Señor que vaya y no peque más.
The man didn't like that.
El hombre no le gustó.
So then he went and found the Sanhedrin to go give Yeshua problems.
Entonces buscó los Sanhedrin y le dieron problemas a Yeshua.
Yes, man.
But also, there was a, I don't remember if he was paralyzed or sick. When the disciples asked him which one of his parents sinned, and he said none. He was blind. He said that he was like that so that for the glory of God, so that God can be glorified through healing him.
That is the exception, but not the rule.
Okay. Mi pregunta fue cuando Yeshua vio cuando Yeshua sanó al ciego. Los discípulos le preguntaron a Yeshua cuáles de sus padres pecaron. Y él dijo, ninguno, sino esto es para la gloria de Dios. Y el rabino dice que esa es la excepción a la regla, no. The exception to the rule.
It's the exception, but not the rule.
Oh, es la excepción, pero no la regla.
Ariana. We got an auction going on downstairs.
Yeah.
Once, twice, sold the man of wine. No.
But that's what he meant to say.
You
know, take the log out of your own eye before seeing the log of your brothers. Since everybody makes mistakes, you know, but people sometimes they don't want to see the mistakes that the people themselves make, but they see the other people, you know. So that's really clear.
Well, let's not take that too far out of a context. Let me paraphrase. The question was about taking the log out of your own eye.
La pregunta fue sobre quitar la viga del ojo.
We are to judge our brothers and sisters, but judge rightly, says Yeshua.
Nosotros estamos supuestos a juzgar a nuestros hermanos y hermanas, pero Yeshua dice que juzgue justamente.
And if you're actively rebelling against the Torah,
y si estás rebelándote activamente en contra Torah,
you're not striving for perfection.
No estás luchando para la perfección.
You're not running towards the Father.
No estás corriendo hacia el Padre.
You've moved his boundary marker.
Has movido su piedra límite.
So when you move his boundary marker,
cuando mueves la piedra límite,
Hosea 5 verse 10 says, I'm going to pour my fury out on you.
Hosea 5 versículo 10 dice, voy a derramar mi furia sobre ti.
And that's what could very likely happen to the world very shortly.
Y eso es lo que puede pasarle al mundo ya pronto.
Oscar!
All right.
Have an apple.
But that's why salvation is personal.
Yes.
Por eso que la salvación es personal.
Right.
Eso es lo que estaba tratando de decir.
Salvation is personal.
La salvación es personal.
But sometimes you have to be taught God's ways.
Pero a veces hay que ser enseñado los caminos de Dios.
That's why the Lord gives you teachers.
Por eso que el Señor te da maestros.
Okay. Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Turn to Matthew 7.
Vamos a Mateo capítulo 7.
Don't worry, yes, they're all going to run away as soon as all hell happens.
Yes, sir.
Then they're all going to come up and try to grab this our seat. Maybe if we did one language, I could go like that too.
That what?
Matthew 7, verse 27. I'm sorry.
Mateo, capítulo 7, versículo 27.
Take a breath. Don't. Now, how many of you guys were at churches that the pastor was like that?
Oh, yeah. Every Pentecostal church, they're like that. Every Pentecostal church is the same.
Will you stop praying?
Matthew 7, verse 27.
Mateo 7, versículo 27.
The rain fell, the rivers flooded, the wind blew and beat against that house, and it collapsed, and its collapse was horrendous. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, so if you don't strive for perfection,
so si no luchas para la perfección,
you move the Father's boundary markers,
mueves el, la piedra límite del Padre,
you don't listen to the warning,
la advertencia,
then when God pours out his fury,
entonces cuando Dios derrama su furia,
the collapse is going to be horrendous.
El colapso va a ser horrible.
That's why it's so important to follow him now.
Por eso que es tan importante seguirlo ahora.
And that's what Yeshua was trying to tell them.
Y eso es lo que Yeshua le estaba tratando de decir.
You already just spent 400 years being conquered.
Has pasado 400 años siendo conquistado.
Between Malachi and Matthew, there's 400 years.
Entre Malaquías y Mateo hay 400 años.
Why do you want to go back to that? Yeshua was saying.
¿Por qué quieres regresar a eso? Está diciendo.
So he's saying, strive for perfection.
So él está diciendo, lucha para la perfección.
Because when God's winds start blowing against you,
porque cuando los vientos de Dios empiecen a soplar en contra de ti.
Remember, Shaul was on the boat in the book of Acts.
Acuérdate que Shaul, Pablo, estaba en el bote en el libro de los Hechos.
And what happened to the ship when he said the storm, when they crashed against the rocks?
¿Y qué sucedió con el barco cuando chocaron contra las piedras?
It was, the collapse was, of the ship was horrendous.
El colapso del barco fue horrible.
You may escape with your life.
Puedes escapar con tu vida.
Or you may not.
O tal vez no.
All depends if you're striving for perfection beforehand.
Todo depende de si estás luchando para la perfección.
Everybody wants to change, after 9/11, what happened?
Después del 9/11, ¿qué sucedió?
The churches were filled up.
Las iglesias estaban llenas.
And that lasted for about 7 weeks.
Y eso duró por lo menos 7 semanas.
And then people started to, that's enough of that.
Y después la gente comenzaron con, ya eso es suficiente.
So when the Lord brings this next chastisement on America,
cuando el Señor traiga esta este próximo castigo sobre América,
I believe his words, it's going to be horrendous.
Yo creo en su palabra que va a ser horrible.
So we have to strive for perfection.
So tenemos que luchar para la perfección.
That is the goal of this ministry.
Esa es la meta de este ministerio.
Teaching you what perfection is.
Enseñándote lo que es la perfección.
Because nobody's out there is doing this.
Porque nadie allá afuera está haciendo esto.
People are, rabbis and pastors are afraid to tell people the truth.
Los rabinos y pastores le tienen miedo decirle la verdad a la gente.
When you see a word like horrendous, you might want to stop and think what that means.
Cuando ves una palabra como esta horrible, tal vez quieras parar y averiguar qué significa esa palabra.
And Matthew 7 follows Matthew 5.
Y Mateo 7 le sigue a Mateo 6.
So here he's telling it, be perfect.
So aquí él está diciendo, sea perfecto.
Now a little while later he's saying, when the rivers flood, it's going to be terrible.
Y un poco después está diciendo que cuando los ríos se inundan va a ser horrible.
Imagine not knowing where you're going to sleep.
Imagínate no saber a dónde vas a dormir.
Imagine things being so bad, there are no houses left.
Imagínate las cosas que sean tan malo que ya no hay casas.
Imagine not knowing where food is going to come from.
Imagínate saber de dónde va a salir la comida.
Or my favorite, toilet paper.
O mi favorito, papel de sifú.
Yes, Claudia.
Claro.
Oh, there are lots of earthquakes going on.
Sí,
and they think the volcanoes are going to erupt now too.
Hay muchos terremotos en Italia y los volcanes van a eruptar.
Yeah, they had another 6-6 on Sunday.
Yeah,
another 6-6 on Sunday. But there's a bigger earthquake coming.
Que hay un terremoto más grande que viene.
One that's going to split Jerusalem into 3 parts.
Una que va a partir a Jerusalén en 3 partes.
Yeah, remember, there's a big fault that goes through Israel.
Acuérdate que hay un fallo grande que va.
It's in the book of Revelation. It'll split the city into 3 parts. You got to read your Bibles. Well, last days and laddies, you got to be reading.
Tienen que leer. Tienen que leer su
All right,
Biblia.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Read the Bible. Okay, let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Turn to Luke 6.
Vamos a Lucas capítulo 6. Luke 6?
Luke 6, 49.
Oh, I see it.
Tristan, can you send Johanna the WebEx number, the WebEx information on Skype, please? So she can go to WebEx. Thank you. Luke 6, verse 49.
Lucas, capítulo 6, versículo
49. Did you learn anything when the pastor was speaking like that?
Rav, I think we've told you. We've told you in a year, we've learned more than we have in 30 years.
Didn't you notice how ignorant we were when we came here?
I try not to. I try not to look at that too often. Luke 6, verse 49.
Lucas, capítulo 6, versículo 49. I mean, all the reallys? Really? Wow. Welcome to Beth Goim. Welcome to Beth Goim. Welcome to Beth Goim.
And whoever hears my words but doesn't act on them is like someone who built his house on the ground without any foundation. As soon as the river struck it, it collapsed, and that house became a horrendous wreck. All right. The key here to the... Let's follow our dots.
Vamos a seguir nuestros puntitos.
In Matthew 5,
Mateo 5,
we start there.
Comenzamos ahí.
Be perfect.
Sea perfecto.
Then we go to Deuteronomy 19.
Entonces vamos a Deuteronomio 19.
Put the boundary stone back.
Regresa la piedra límite.
We go to Hosea 5.
Vamos a Hosea 5.
If you don't put it back,
si no lo regresa,
the father is going to be really angry and pour out his fury on
el padre
you.
Se va a enojar contigo y va a derramar su furia.
Then Matthew 7,
y Mateo 7,
Yeshua is talking about you didn't build the foundation.
Yeshua está hablando de que no pusiste el cimiento.
You think you got a good house,
crees que tiene una casa buena,
but as soon as the ground shakes,
pero cuando la tierra tiembla,
it's going to collapse like that in Italy.
Se va a colapsar como aquellos en Italia.
Then we go to Luke 6.
Entonces vamos a Lucas 6.
Yeshua is saying, if you don't act on his word,
Yeshua dice, si no actúas en su palabra,
then it's going to be even more so for you.
Y entonces va a ser más peor para ti.
Okay? So that is the key.
Esa es la clave.
Acting on God's word.
Actuando en la palabra de Dios.
That's why every congregation should be an education ministry.
Tomando acción en la palabra de Dios. Por eso que cada congregation
an education
tiene que ser educado. Sorry.
Okay? Because I don't want your life to end up as a wreck.
No quiero que tu vida termine
something bad.
Como un desastre.
Okay? The goal is to make your lives better.
La meta es para hacer de sus vidas mejor.
The goal is to strive for perfection.
La meta es luchar para la perfección.
And that's why we talk about the law so much here.
Y por eso que hablamos tanto sobre la ley aquí.
Because the law is perfect.
Porque la ley es perfecta.
And you want to strive to win. You want to get to the end of the race.
Y quieres luchar para llegar al final de la carrera.
So here, Yeshua is saying, act on these words.
Yeshua aquí está diciendo, actúe sobre estas palabras.
Adriana?
Life or the
Well,
and if you look at the lives of the disciples, they're struggling.
Well, let's take a look at that. Adriana was saying the secular world says one thing.
Adriana estaba diciendo que el mundo secular dice una cosa.
Let's take a look at a few famous people.
Vamos a mirar a un par de famosos.
Who died horrible lives.
Que murieron vidas que murieron horriblemente.
You look at a person like Elvis Presley.
Miras una persona como Elvis Presley.
Started out singing gospel in the church.
Comenzó cantando música evangélica en la iglesia.
Had a tremendous, beautiful voice.
Tenía tremenda voz.
Handsome gentleman.
Era atractivo.
Made lots of records that people loved.
Hizo muchos discos que la gente le gusta.
Married a beautiful woman.
Se casó con una mujer bien,
but that
bien
wasn't
bonita.
Enough for him.
Pero eso no era suficiente.
His
para
movies did well.
Sus películas hicieron, fueron,
won awards for them.
Ganaron premios por
his records exitosos. Did well.
Sus discos fueron exitosos.
But
exitosos.
How did he die?
Pero ¿cómo murió?
Drugs on the toilet.
Con drogas encima de un inodoro.
Another famous person.
Otra persona famosa.
Marilyn Monroe.
Marilyn Monroe.
Many men thought she was extraordinarily beautiful.
Muchos hombres pensaban que ella era extraordinariamente bella.
No children.
No tenía hijos.
Movies made money.
Sus películas hicieron dinero.
She committed suicide.
Ella se suicidó.
So what is our goal?
¿Cuál es
of perfection?
Para perfección.
Shalom.
Shalom.
In your life.
En tu vida.
When you can look at your life
cuando
and go,
tú,
everything's good.
Cuando tú miras tu vida y dices todo está bien.
My marriage is good.
Mi matrimonio está
my
bien.
My life is good.
Mi vida está bien.
We got enough money.
Tenemos suficiente dinero.
We got a place to live.
Tenemos a donde vivir.
Everything's good.
Todo está bien.
Shalom.
Shalom.
You know, rock stars. Jimi Hendrix.
Estrellas de rock. Jimi Hendrix.
Everybody wanted to be him.
Todos querían ser como él.
Died of a drug overdose.
Murió de un sobredosis de droga.
How many music artists can we name?
¿Cuántos artistas musicales podemos nombrar?
Who had money.
Que tenían dinero.
Fame.
Fama.
Fortunes.
Fortuna. Héctor Lavoe.
Yeah, whatever culture, you can name it.
Cualquier cultura lo puedes nombrar.
So striving for perfection. So,
luchando para la perfección.
We're in a class here. Striving for perfection.
Luchando para la perfección.
Is acting on Yeshua's words.
Es actuando en las palabras de Yeshua.
Because he says, my shalom I give to you.
Porque él dice, mi shalom os doy.
And that's why we're doing this study on Matthew 5.
Por eso que estamos haciendo este estudio en Mateo capítulo 5.
It's one of the most incredible chapters of all the Bible.
Es uno de los capítulos más increíbles de toda la Biblia.
So you want to strive for perfection?
So quieres luchar para la perfección?
You want to put the marker back where it belonged after you learn where it belongs?
Quieres regresar la piedra de límite a donde pertenece después que aprende o sepas a donde pertenece.
You want to keep the Father happy so he doesn't pour his fury out on you or others?
Quieres mantener al Padre alegre para que no derrame su furia sobre ti o otros?
You want to build your house and your life on a solid foundation.
¿Quieres edificar tu casa y tu vida sobre el cimiento sólido?
You want to act on Yeshua's words.
¿Quieres actuar en las palabras de Yeshua?
Going on to the next slide.
En la próxima página.
Turn to Revelation 20, please.
Vamos a Revelaciones capítulo 20. Revelación capítulo 20.
Revelation 20, verse 12.
Apocalipsis 20, versículo 12.
Down at the bottom.
Revelation 20, verse 12.
Apocalipsis 20, versículo 12.
Revelation 20, Revelation 20, verse 12.
Apocalipsis 20, versículo 12.
You guys on WebEx, you can turn on your camera so we can see you. Make sure you're paying attention.
Don't be shy. Don't be camera
Revelation
shy.
20, verse 12.
Apocalipsis 20, versículo
12. Allie's eating dinner. Hi, guys. Ellie Shave is eating dinner. And I saw the dead, both great and small, standing in front of the throne. Books were open, and another book was open, the book of life. The dead were judged from what was written in the books according to what they had done. Okay, there's seven parts to this sentence.
Hay siete partes a este versículo.
Okay, the dead is one.
Los muertos son uno.
Books were opened, two.
Libros fueron abiertos, dos.
Another book was opened, three.
Otro libro fue abierto, tres.
Book of life, four.
Libro de vida, cuatro.
Dead were judged, five.
Los muertos fueron juzgados, cinco.
Written in the book, six.
Escrito en los libros, seis.
And what they had done, seven.
Y lo que han hecho, siete.
That goes back to Matthew 5, verse 48.
Eso nos lleva de nuevo a Mateo capítulo 5, versículo
48. Yeshua says, be perfect.
Yeshua dice, seas perfecto.
For your Father in heaven is perfect.
Porque tu Padre en el cielo es perfecto.
Because you're going to be judged.
Porque vas a ser juzgado.
According to what you have done.
De acuerdo con lo que has hecho.
Well, I was in church every December 24th at midnight mass.
Yo estaba en la iglesia cada 24 de diciembre en la misa de la medianoche.
We had the biggest, best Christmas tree ever.
Teníamos el mejor árbol de Navidad.
What are you going to be judged on?
¿En qué vas a ser juzgado?
Did you act on Yeshua's words?
¿Actuaste en las palabras de Yeshua?
Or did you act on what you thought Paul said about Yeshua?
¿O actuaste en lo que tú pensaste que Pablo dijo sobre
Remember,
Yeshua?
Paul only met with the disciples for 2 weeks.
Acuérdate que Pablo solamente se encontró con los discípulos por 2 semanas.
Okay, so being perfect
siendo perfecto,
is knowing that you're going to be, your life is going to be judged.
Es sabiendo que tu vida va a ser juzgada.
On what you have done.
En lo que has hecho.
Okay, this in the verse, the beginning part of verse 12.
El comienzo del versículo 12.
It said the dead were judged.
Dice que los muertos fueron juzgados.
That means everybody's going to be judged because everybody's going to die at least once.
Eso quiere decir que todos van a ser juzgados porque todos van a morir una vez.
There are two exceptions.
Hay dos excepciones.
Enoch. And Elisha.
Y Eliseo.
Okay.
Eliseo.
We don't see anybody else being raptured.
No vemos a otros siendo raptados.
Okay, we'll be caught up in the sky. That's after everybody's pretty much dead.
Elias.
Okay. So here, why is this written in Revelation 20, verse 12?
¿Por qué fue esto escrito en Apocalipsis 20, versículo 12?
Because it follows what Yeshua said in Matthew 5, verse 48.
Porque sigue lo que Yeshua dijo en Mateo, capítulo 5, versículo 48.
Well, we can't be perfect.
Pero no pueden ser perfecto.
You could try.
Puedes intentarlo.
A lot better than you are.
Más de lo que eres.
You can't go wrong with doing what Yeshua did.
No te puedes equivocar en hacer lo que Yeshua hizo.
But you can go wrong.
Pero sí te puedes equivocar.
In doing something he didn't do.
En hacer algo que él no hizo.
Well, we're not under that anymore.
Pero ya no estamos bajo eso.
Evidently, we are.
Evidentemente, sí.
So is God going to judge this, everybody after the cross differently?
¿Dios va a juzgar a todos después de la cruz diferente?
Yes, he is.
Sí.
It's now personal.
Es ahora personal.
It's very personal.
Es muy personal.
Before, you know, you had the high priest.
Antes tenía el
did the offering.
Hizo la ofrenda.
And, you know, your sins were forgiven once a year.
Tus pecados fueron perdonados una vez al año.
Now it's personal.
Ahora es personal.
So that's what changed.
Eso fue lo que cambió.
Yeshua took the ball and threw it to you.
Y Yeshua tomó la bola y te lo tiró a ti.
And it's your choice to do what you want.
Y depende de ti para elegir lo que
Now, is it going to be easy? No.
¿Va a ser fácil? No.
But living in a real good neighborhood,
pero viviendo en una un vecindario
called bueno, heaven,
que se llama el cielo,
where the streets are gold,
a donde las calles son de oro.
Well, you got to do some work to get there.
Tienes que trabajar un poco para llegar.
Because salvation is a gift.
La salvación es un don.
And now you got to change what you used to have in your life.
Y ahora tienes que cambiar lo que tú antes tenías en tu vida.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
There were two books.
The books were open,
los libros fueron abiertos,
which are the Torah,
que son la Torah,
and another book, the Book of Life.
Y otro libro, el libro de la vida.
Moshe referenced the Book of Life when he talks to God to take his name out of it.
Moshe le hizo referencia al libro de la vida cuando él le pidió a Dios que le quitara su nombre de ahí.
Now, what books would John be referring to?
¿Cuáles libros se refiere Juan?
The first five books.
Los primeros cinco libros.
Since the New Testament is not written.
Como el Nuevo Testamento no fue escrito todavía.
Okay, it's not written where everybody would see the letters to Ephesians.
Donde todos puedan ver la carta a los Efesios.
If you lived in Corinth.
Si vivías en Corinto.
Okay.
And the Book of Life is where our actions are.
Speak up a little bit. I have the dork downstairs. The Book of Life is where your name, your personal name is going to be.
El libro de la vida es a donde tu nombre personal va a estar.
It'll be a reservation for one.
Va a haber reservaciones para uno.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, so the last part of the sentence, that's where our actions will be written in the books.
Yeah. If. See, God already knows.
Si ya Dios sabe.
Because you're going to be judged on what you've done.
Porque va a ser juzgado en lo que has hecho.
If you don't keep Sabbath,
si no guardas el Shabbat,
your name is not there.
Tu nombre no está ahí.
Since the Sabbath is in the Bible one in the King James 120 times.
Como el Shabbat se encuentra en el La Reina Valera 120 veces.
And that Bible that was donated is a full testament.
Y la Biblia que fue donado es un testamento completo.
Okay, so you're going to be judged.
Tú vas a ser juzgado.
According to God's standards.
De acuerdo a los estándares de Dios.
And Torah lives inside of you.
Y la Torah vive dentro de ti.
Because when Adam bit the fruit, all knowledge was placed inside of him and his children.
Porque cuando Adán comió de la fruta, todo conocimiento fue puesto adentro de él y sus hijos.
Okay. So that's why Yeshua said in Matthew 5 verse 48.
Por eso que Yeshua dice en Mateo 5 versículo 48,
be perfect for your Father in heaven is perfect.
Seas perfecto porque tu Padre en el cielo es perfecto.
Ariana, speak up a little bit. Yes. Well, since we only know of these two sets of books.
Solamente sabemos de estos dos de este set de libro.
The animals have to live according to God's plan.
Los animales tienen que vivir de acuerdo al plan de Dios.
So if a lion eats a human,
y si un león se come a un humano,
that lion will not be in heaven.
Ese león no va a estar en el cielo.
And we know this from Genesis chapter 9.
Y sabemos esto de Génesis capítulo 9.
9:6.
9:6.
You got to speak up because they're now finishing up their 15-minute service.
The animals
all dogs go to heaven.
Todos los perros van al cielo.
The dead were judged from what was written in the books, Torah.
Okay,
yeah. Torah is referred to as the books.
Los muertos fueron juzgados de acuerdo a lo que estaba escrito en los libros.
It's called the five books of Moses.
Los libros se refieren a la Torah. Son los cinco libros de Moisés.
So all the dead,
so todos los muertos,
are going to be judged according to that, and this is in the New Testament.
Van a ser juzgados de acuerdo de eso. Now, y esto se encuentra en el Nuevo Testamento.
This might be scary for some of you.
Tal vez esto le asuste.
Because the froofy nuts downstairs don't teach this. So
porque,
all these people are going to hell.
Porque esta gente de abajo no enseñan esto. Or at least, toda esta gente van al infierno.
At least 75%.
Por lo menos 75%.
And how can I say that?
¿Y cómo puedo decir eso?
Well, you're going to be judged according to the books.
Va a ser juzgado de acuerdo a los libros.
And God said, keep my Sabbath holy.
Y Dios dijo, guarda mi Shabbat santo.
Yes, sir. You set up your, it's usually when you're going to ask a question. All right. And going on to the next slide.
Wow.
What?
They just got like three times louder.
I'm praying for a building.
So am I.
I would love a place of our own, but right now. I'm still waiting on him. You know, I'm waiting to, I'm definitely not making any decisions till after November 8th.
Oh, I see.
November 8th is going to be a big day. Well, maybe it might push into the 9th. I don't think it's going to be close.
It's the 8th or the 11th?
It's November 8th.
Election day.
Just got the ballot today in the mail.
It's 8 days away.
Seven.
7 days away, right. Yeah.
Yeah. Should prove to be a very interesting day. All right, let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
All right. Hey, everybody, yay! They're finishing, yay.
Baruch Hashem.
They got their 5-minute message of, you know, buying stuff at the... Next slide. Beatitudes. Like I said, this is review.
Las bienaventuranzas.
We talked about the Beatitudes.
Hablamos sobre las bienaventuranzas.
Comes from the Latin word beatus.
Viene de la palabra latín beatis.
Referring to the 9 blessedness.
Que se refiere a las 9 bendiciones.
Going on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Okay, let's take a quick rundown.
Vamos a mirar ligeramente.
On how this is, how chapter 5. The Beatitudes are broken down.
¿Cómo se divide las bienaventuranzas?
Okay, if you, like I said, we're going rapidly. Go back to part number 2, I think. I did this. No, part number 1.
Oh, part number 1.
I don't know. I don't remember.
Yeah.
Okay. Number 1, poor in spirit.
Número 1, pobres en espíritu.
Ties together with the kingdom of heaven.
Se une con el reino del cielo.
And we'll get to that next week.
Y vamos a entrar a eso la semana que viene.
I think you'll find it very interesting.
Pienso que lo vas a encontrar bien interesante.
Okay, number 2.
Número 2.
Those who mourn is put together with comforted.
Aquellos que lamentan se une con siendo confortado, consolado.
Number 3.
Número 3.
Meek does not mean weak.
Humilde no significa débil.
Is tied together with inherit.
Y se une con herencia, heredar.
Number 4.
Número 4.
Hunger and thirst for righteousness.
Hambre y sed para la justicia.
Is tied together with being filled.
Se une con ser satisfecho.
See, the way to think of the people downstairs,
la manera de pensar de la gente de abajo,
think of them as the 5,000.
Piensa de ellos como los 5,000.
Where were they when Yeshua was being crucified?
¿A dónde estaban cuando Yeshua fue crucificado?
They weren't there.
No estaban ahí.
So when they're judged,
so cuando son juzgados,
it's not going to be good.
No va a ser, no va
and
ser
then
bueno.
When hell hits the fan,
y cuando el infierno choque contra el abanico,
people that focus on the physical,
las personas que se enfocan en lo físico,
will not make it through the fire.
No van a pasar por el fuego.
Number 5.
Número 5.
Mercy is tied together with mercy.
Misericordia se une con misericordia.
Number 6.
Número 6.
Pure in heart. This puro, is really a big one.
Puros de corazón. Yeah.
pure in heart,
puros de corazón,
they will see God.
Van a ver a Dios.
Number 7.
Número 7.
Peace or shalom,
paz o shalom,
is tied together with the sons of God.
Se une con los hijos de Dios.
Sons of God.
Hijos de Dios.
Number 8.
Número 8.
Persecution for righteousness,
persecución por la justicia,
is tied together with the kingdom of heaven.
Está unido con el reino del cielo.
And then finally,
y finalmente,
number 9.
Número 9.
Insult, persecute, vicious lies is tied together with you follow me.
Insultos, persecución y mentiras viciosas se une con tú, síganme.
Once again, we did go over this.
Nuevamente nosotros ya
I see some writing going on, so I'll
veo que están escribiendo sobre.
I'll give you a second to write this.
Me voy a detener un minuto.
This is also part of one of the questions.
Esto también es parte de una de las preguntas.
Remember, this is a study which you're going to get a certificate if you answer the questions and do the exam.
Acuérdate que vas a obtener un certificado.
Yeah, si we're taking this to a whole other level. I'm an idiot.
Tomas un examen.
Okay. Excuse me?
Humilde.
I'll make it available so you can do an online test. Yep. Well, I have
no
to be.
No significa debilidad.
It's going to be a written. I'll have it translated into Spanish, maybe. But yes, what the Lord has impressed upon me to take this ministry to a much, in certain areas, to a higher level.
El Señor me ha impresionado tomar este ministerio a otro nivel más alto.
Shabbat messages usually have 3 categories.
Los mensajes de Shabbat normalmente tienen 3 categorías.
Each message will have a beginning level, an intermediate, and an expert.
Cada mensaje va a tener un nivel básico, intermediario y más alto nivel.
Masters, yeah.
Más alto.
Okay, but the Bible study is going to be real high level from
pero now. El estudio bíblico va a ser a un alto nivel.
So make sure you make it to all your Bible studies. So
asegúrate que llegues a todos los estudios bíblicos.
Or at minimum, watch it on before the next study.
Al mínimo, mírenlo antes del próximo estudio.
Okay, because sometimes you can't make it on a Tuesday.
Porque hay veces que no puedes llegar el martes.
But we will always, I will record them and have the questions for you.
Yo lo grabaré y tendré las preguntas para ti.
Because what the Lord has impressed upon me is to make good leaders.
Lo que el Señor me ha impresionado es hacer buenos líderes.
That know the Word of God very thoroughly.
Que conocen la palabra de Dios completamente.
Because if there's a time coming where we can't meet,
porque si hay un tiempo a donde no nos podemos reunir,
at least for a time period, people will be seeking God.
Por un tiempo, la gente van a estar buscando a Dios.
And you're going to need to be leaders.
Y van a necesitar ser líderes.
And you want to be a schooled leader.
Y quiere ser un líder educado.
Because to much is given, much is required.
Porque a quien mucho es dado, mucho es requerido.
Going on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Hosea 4, verse 6, please.
Hosea 4, capítulo, versículo 6, por favor.
Hosea 4, verse 6.
Hosea, capítulo 4, versículo 6.
Okay.
Review.
This is all review.
Todo esto es un repaso.
Yeah. Because it's been 3 weeks since we did this study, so I wanted to get us back into
the groove.
The groove, and then next week's class is mostly done. It's quite fascinating. Yes, ma'am. Well, if all the men are dead, like they were in Uganda, And you're to train your children.
Y estás puesto a entrenar tus hijos.
The mother's job is to train up the child.
La función de la madre es a criar el hijo.
So that then, when let's say one of your sons becomes 20, he can become a leader.
Ya cuando si digamos uno de tus hijos llegue a 20 años puede ser un líder.
This is what our country is missing.
Esto es lo que le falta a nuestra.
Men that have character.
Hombres de carácter.
Men that have a fear of God.
Hombres que temen a Dios.
Okay. So, men that are not narcissists.
Hombres que no son narcisistas.
Women, that's his hair.
Yeah, that's huge.
And then we'll do the other one.
That's the Wicked Witch of the West.
She is a witch.
Who's afraid of the big bad witch?
Okay, let's stay away from politics. It's useless. Both are disgusting. Hosea 4, verse 6.
Hosea 4, capítulo, versículo 6.
But it is interesting, all of his children married Jews.
Pero es bien interesante que todos sus hijos de Trump se casaron con judíos.
Yes. And so did Hillary's.
And one of them's a rabbi. Right?
No.
No?
All the children are married to Jews.
Todos
Chelsea is married to a Jew.
Chelsea está casado con...
And Ducks, two kids are married to Jews.
It's Ducks.
Donald Duck.
Oh, Donald Trump. También está casado con
and his other daughter is dating a Jew.
Yeah,
no, his children, his one daughter converted to Judaism.
Su hija se convirtió al judaísmo.
The other one just married a Jew.
La otra se casó con un judío.
Anyway, back to Hosea 4, verse 6.
Hosea, capítulo 4, versículo 6.
My people are destroyed for want of knowledge. Because you rejected knowledge, I will also reject you as Cohen from me. Because you forgot the Torah of your Elohim, I will also forget your children. So when people say there's not a generational curse,
so cuando la gente dice que no hay maldición generacional,
then you have not read your Bible.
Entonces no has leído tu Biblia.
The father says, I'm going to forget your kids.
El padre dice que me voy a olvidar de tus hijos.
So you can pray for them all you want.
So puedes orar por ellos todo lo que quieras.
Because you don't want knowledge. Knowledge of what?
Porque no quieres conocimiento.
Knowledge of being perfect.
Conocimiento de ser perfecto.
That's why Yeshua said it.
Por eso que Yeshua lo dijo.
And he died in 33.
Y murió en el 33.
And when was the temple destroyed?
Y cuando fue el templo destruido? 70.
So it didn't take long for them to forget all of Yeshua's wonderful miracles.
So no tomó mucho tiempo para que ellos se olvidaran de todos los milagros de Yeshua.
That's why knowledge is so important and education is so important.
Por eso que el conocimiento es tan importante y la educación es tan importante.
The key to this particular verse,
la clave para este versículo en particular.
Number one, my people.
Número uno, mi pueblo.
Number two, destroyed.
Número dos, destruido.
Number three, want.
Falta.
Number four, rejected.
Número cuatro, rechazado.
Number five, rejected a second time.
Número cinco, rechazado una segunda vez.
Number six, Cohen.
Número seis, sacerdote.
Number seven, forget.
Número siete, olvidado.
Number eight, forget your children.
Y número ocho, olvidar tus hijos.
And all because you wanted something.
Y todo porque querías algo.
In the first part of the sentence, the first sentence in the verse.
En la primera parte de la oración del versículo.
My people are destroyed for want of knowledge.
Mi pueblo está destruido por falta de conocimiento.
That's, you go to your pastors, you go to your rabbis, you go to your messianic rabbis.
Tú vas a tus pastores, tú vas a tus rabinos, vas a tus rabinos mesiánicos.
And you ask questions.
Y le haces preguntas.
And evidently, since you're here.
Y evidentemente porque estás aquí.
Those pastors and rabbis didn't satisfy your quest for knowledge.
Esos pastores y rabinos no satisfacieron tu busca de conocimiento.
So my job is, because you want something, I'm going to tell you the truth.
Y mi trabajo es porque que quieres algo, yo te voy a decir la verdad.
Going on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
We're looking at the word rejected.
Estamos mirando la palabra rechazado.
The Hebrew word is ma'as.
La palabra hebrea es ma'as.
A lot of us have felt this.
Muchos de nosotros hemos sentido
you try to tell people about the Shabbat.
Tratas de decirle a la gente de Shabbat.
And what happens?
¿Y qué sucede?
Oh, we don't got to do that.
No, no tenemos que hacer eso.
No, it doesn't matter what day you worship.
No importa qué día te adoras.
Evidently to God it does.
Evidentemente a Dios sí.
And since God doesn't change,
y como Dios no cambia,
it's better to be rejected by people than it is by God.
Es mejor ser rechazado por la gente que por Dios.
Okay? So rejected is ma'as.
So rechazado es ma'as.
Knowledge is da'at.
Sabiduría es da'at.
People reject knowledge.
El pueblo rechaza conocimiento.
Wisdom.
Sabiduría.
Okay. People, why did God say,
¿Por qué Dios dijo?
Don't sow your seeds, don't plant something between your rows of plants.
No siembre otra semilla en medio de tu cosecha.
And that was a good study on in the Road to Emmaus class on Shabbat.
Eso fue un buen estudio en el camino a Emmaus el Shabbat.
And everybody was in agreement with why God said that.
Y todos estaban de acuerdo porque Dios dijo eso.
But then when we went back to stoning the vile child.
Pero entonces cuando regresamos a pedrar el hijo malcriado.
We couldn't some people couldn't agree with that.
Muchos no podían estar de acuerdo.
So you agree with the seeds.
Estás de acuerdo con las
semillas. But you don't agree with stoning the kid that's stealing your stuff.
Pero no estás de acuerdo con el hijo que te está robando.
Okay, well, God said I'm going to forget your kids.
Okay, pues Dios dijo que voy a olvidar tus hijos.
I'll get your attention, he says.
Yo voy a agarrar tu atención, él dice.
Some people it gets their attention, and some people don't really care.
Algunos le agarra la atención y hay otros que no le importa.
Next slide.
En la próxima página.
Go to the next. Skip that slide.
Vamos a saltar esa página.
Let's go to Matthew 5.
Vamos a Mateo capítulo 5.
Let's go to verse 1 and 2.
Vamos al versículo 1 y 2.
Everybody good on WebEx? You good, Diana? Good, Joanne? How's the new job? Fun?
Mazel tov.
Don't start till Monday.
Oh, okay. Matthew 5, verse 1.
Mateo 5, versículo 1.
And 2.
Y 2.
Seeing the crowd, Yeshua walked up the hill. After he sat down, his Talmudim came to him, and he began to speak. This is what he taught them. Two key words in verse 2.
Dos palabras claves en el versículo 2.
One is speak.
Uno es hablar.
And the other is taught.
Y el otro es enseñó.
The word for speak in the Greek.
La palabra para hablar en el griego.
Is stoma.
Es stoma.
Means a part of a body of man, animals, or fish.
Significa parte del cuerpo de hombre, animales, o pescado.
That comes your verbal utterance.
De sale, de donde sale palabras, tu voz.
Okay. What comes out of your mouth comes from your heart or your soul.
Lo que sale de tu boca sale del corazón o de tu alma.
And sometimes you make a blunder.
Y hay veces que blunder.
Make an error.
Que cometes un error.
Okay? You make an error in letting something out from the old you.
Hay veces que dejas que salga algo del viejo tú.
Anybody ever make that one?
Yeah.
The old you pops out.
It just popped out.
And people, believers and followers of Yeshua should be forgiving, but they're not.
Los seguidores de Yeshua deben de ser perdonar, pero no perdonan.
A lot of times believers are worse than the seculars.
Muchas veces los creyentes son peores que los seculares.
Okay. So the word stoma.
So la palabra stoma
is coming out of your mouth,
saliendo de tu boca,
which comes from your heart.
Que viene de tu corazón.
Going on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Okay, so let's take a quick gander at the word speak.
Vamos a mirar la palabra hablar.
Hold your place in Matthew 5.
Mantén tu lugar en Mateo 5.
Turn to Proverbs 8.
Vamos a Proverbios capítulo 8.
Proverbs 8.
Proverbios capítulo 8.
As once again I said, this is review.
Nuevamente esto es un repaso.
For next week when we get to verse 3.
Para la semana que viene cuando lleguemos al versículo 3.
And I think I'm already up to 30 slides and I only got to the first word. Proverbs 8, verse 1 through 7.
Proverbios 8, versículos 1 al 7.
And this was, we're focusing on the word speak.
Y nos estamos enfocando en la palabra hablar.
Proverbs 8, verse 1 through 7.
Proverbios capítulo 8, versículos 1 al 7.
Wisdom is calling, understanding is raising her voice. On the heights along the road where the paths meet, she is standing by the gates leading into the city. At the entrances, she cries aloud, "People, I am calling you, raising my voice to all mankind. You who don't direct your lives, understand caution. As for you, you fools, get some common sense. Listen, I will say worthwhile things. When I speak, my words are right. My mouth says what is true because my lips detest evil." Amen?
Amen.
Now, I know this might be hard to understand, but please go to our Yeshua study.
Yo sé que esto puede ser difícil para entender, pero por favor, miren nuestro estudio sobre Yeshua.
The study on what was Yeshua created?
El estudio de que fue Yeshua creado.
Because a lot of people don't understand the term "her," and this was referring to Yeshua.
Y mucha gente no entiende el término ella, y esto se refiere a Yeshua.
So we go through the whole reason why the word "her" is used.
Y nosotros damos varias razones porque se usa la palabra ella.
But our key verse is 6 and 7.
Pero nuestro versículos claves es el 6 y el 7.
Listen, I will say worthwhile things. When I speak, my words are right. My mouth says what is true because my lips detest evil. Okay, so here in Matthew 5,
aquí en Mateo 5,
verse 2,
versículo 2,
Yeshua began to speak.
Yeshua comenzó a hablar.
Everything he was going to say thereafter,
the what?
Everything that he was going to say thereafter, following, is going to lead to Matthew 5, verse 48.
Nos va a llevar a Mateo capítulo 5, versículo 48.
So in Proverbs 8, verse 6 and 7.
So en Proverbios capítulo 8, versículo 6 y 7.
Wisdom is calling.
La sabiduría llama.
Going to say worthwhile things.
Va a decir cosas que valgan la pena.
And in the Beatitudes, you're going to see some amazing things.
En las bienaventuranzas vas a ver cosas bien asombrosas.
And how worthwhile they actually are.
Y como cuánto vale la pena.
In verse 7,
versículo 7,
wisdom is saying that his lips detest evil.
La sabiduría dice que sus labios detestan la maldad.
So what would be evil?
¿Qué será la maldad?
Broccoli.
Broccoli.
Right? Broccoli is evil.
Brussels sprouts.
Cauliflower is evil.
Cauliflower.
Lima beans.
Favas.
What?
Favas?
Okay, well that... All right, so we got the word?
Yeah.
All right, so... Yeah.
Proverbs were written by Shlomo.
Yes.
So he knew Yeshua.
Yes.
That's why he wrote this.
Yes, he knew Yeshua. Yes. So... this is Yeshua talking in verse 6 and 7.
Este es Yeshua hablando en versículo 6 y 7.
Because he says, all wisdom and knowledge has been given to me.
Porque él dijo, toda sabiduría y conocimiento me fue dado.
So when you see the word speak,
so cuando ves la palabra hablar,
your reference is that everything that's going to come out of his mouth is going to lead you away from the devil.
Tu referencia es que todo lo que sale de su boca te va a guiar. Te aleja del diablo.
Okay, and it's going to lead you
because
it's going to lead you to perfection.
Y te va a guiar hacia la perfección.
And what's perfect?
¿Y qué es perfecto?
The laws of God are perfect.
Las leyes de Dios son perfectas.
Going on to the next slide.
En la próxima página.
Proverbs 2, please.
Proverbios capítulo 2, por favor.
The world is in the eyes of Hashem.
Okay.
The word and 8:6 is the same as Shema.
La palabra escuchar ahí en 8:6 es igual que
the word listen.
La palabra escuche.
Let me just make sure. Shema. It's Shema.
La palabra ahí es Shema.
Okay. So we're now in Proverbs 2.
Ahora estamos en Proverbio 2.
We're focusing on the word speak.
Nos estamos enfocando en la palabra hablar.
So once you understand what the word speak is,
ya cuando entiendas lo que es la palabra hablar,
in a biblical sense,
en un sentido bíblico,
and you, this is what's starting off the chapter.
Y esto es comenzando el capítulo.
This is what's starting off a very, very intricate teaching from Messiah.
Y esto es lo que esto es comenzando una enseñanza bien intricate.
In many parts.
De muchas partes es una enseñanza.
Very in depth.
Muy profundo.
Okay. So that you have to understand these key words.
Tienes que entender estas palabras claves.
Okay. So Proverbs 2 verse 6, for Jehovah gives wisdom from his mouth.
Proverbios 2 versículo 6, que Jehovah da sabiduría de su boca.
Comes knowledge and understanding.
Viene sabiduría y entendimiento.
Okay, so when Yeshua is speaking,
so cuando Yeshua está hablando,
he's speaking for his Father.
Está hablando por su Padre.
Because he said, I and the Father are one.
Porque él dijo, yo y el Padre somos uno.
So what's going to come out of Yeshua's mouth is great wisdom.
Lo que va a salir de la boca de Yeshua es gran sabiduría.
Okay.
Y la palabra para intricate es intricado.
Intricado.
Intrincado. Intrincado. I got it right here. Intrincado. Dice I-N-T-R-I-N-C-A-D-O.
That's what the dictionary says.
That's
or go
what
with
the
it.
Dictionary says.
Okay, so
intrincado.
We need to understand what this word speak.
Necesitamos saber de esta palabra hablar.
So he's not going to. Yeshua is not going to contradict the law at all.
Yeshua no va a contradecir la ley.
Since the word speak confirms the laws of God.
Porque la palabra hablar confirma las leyes de Dios.
Going on to the next slide.
En la próxima página.
Proverbs 4, please.
Proverbios 4, por favor.
Verses 20 through 23.
Complejo, complicado.
We're focusing on the word speak.
Estamos enfocándonos en la palabra hablar.
Mishael 4, verse 20 to 23.
Proverbios 4, versículos 20 al 23.
My son, pay attention to what I am saying. Incline your ear to my words. Don't let them out of your sight. Keep them deep in your heart, for they are life to those who find them and health to their whole being. Above everything else, guard your heart, for it is a source of life's consequences. Okay? So here we start off in verse 20.
So aquí comenzamos con el versículo 20.
Incline your ear to the words.
Inclina tu oído a mis palabras.
So pay attention to what Yeshua is going to say.
So presta atención de lo que va a decir Yeshua.
Because in it is going to be great wisdom.
Porque en él se encontrará gran sabiduría.
Blessed are the poor in spirit.
Bienaventurados los pobres de espíritu.
For theirs is the kingdom of God.
Porque de ellos es el reino de Dios.
Incline your ears to what this means.
Inclina tu oído a qué significa esto.
Okay, verse 22.
Versículo 22.
For they are life to those who find them and health to their whole being. Okay, so when you find God's word,
so cuando encuentras la palabra de Dios,
what is going to be taught to you,
lo que te va a ser enseñado,
what is going to be taught to you,
lo que te va a ser enseñado,
is going to be life.
Va a ser vida.
And what is the ultimate life?
¿Y cuál es la vida última?
What did we read in Revelation 20?
¿Qué leímos en Apocalipsis 20?
You're going to be judged on what?
¿Tú vas a ser juzgado en qué?
According to what you've done.
De acuerdo a lo que has hecho.
According to the Torah.
De acuerdo a la Torah.
Okay, Michaela, you have a question? Go ahead.
It can wait till the end.
Okay, we'll wait till the end. All right, and then verse 23.
Y versículo 23.
Above everything else, guard your heart, for it is the source of life's consequences. So guarding your heart,
guardando tu corazón,
with these teachings that Yeshua is going to do.
Con estas enseñanzas que Yeshua va a dar.
And what was verse 48 in Matthew 5?
¿Y cuál fue versículo 48 en Mateo
Be
5?
Perfect.
Sean perfecto.
For your Father in heaven is perfect.
Porque tu Padre en el cielo es perfecto.
You might fall a little short.
Tal vez te falta un poco.
Right. But what God is looking for is somebody who tries.
Pero lo que Dios está buscando es alguien que intente.
Because Yeshua said what?
Porque Yeshua dijo que,
follow me.
Sígame.
Follow me.
Sígame.
So guard your heart.
So guarda tu corazón.
Because where your heart goes, the rest of your body goes.
Porque de donde va tu corazón, tu cuerpo sigue.
Because most of the time, the heart overrules the head.
Porque la mayor parte del tiempo, o la mayoría de veces, el corazón gobierna la cabeza.
And we can see that time after time after time.
Y podemos ver eso tras todas las veces.
Because you'll see people doing absolutely strange things.
Porque vas a ver que la gente hace cosas absolutamente extrañas.
And you're like, what are you doing?
Y tú estás como, ¿qué estás haciendo?
And their heart
y sus corazones
is overruling what is logical.
Está gobernando lo que es lógico.
Going on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Let's go to the law of first reference to speaking.
Vamos a la ley de primera referencia del hablar.
Genesis 18, verse 26 to 28.
Génesis capítulo 18, versículos 26 al 28.
Genesis 18.
Génesis capítulo 18.
Verse 26 to 28.
Versículos 26 al 28.
Law of first reference to speak.
La ley de primera referencia sobre el hablar.
Genesis 18.
Génesis capítulo 18.
Jehovah said, if I find in Sodom 50 who are righteous, and I will forgive the whole place for their sake. Abraham answered, hear now, I who am but dust and ashes have taken it upon myself to speak to Jehovah. What if there were five less than 50 righteous? He said, I won't destroy it if I find five. Find 45 there. Amen? Speaking is to intercede for other people.
Hablando es interceder por otros.
So here Abraham was speaking on behalf of people he didn't even know.
Aquí Abraham estaba intercediendo por gente que él no conocía.
And so this first reference to speak saves you from destruction.
Say that again.
The first reference of to speak.
La primera referencia del hablar.
If there were enough righteous people,
si habían suficientes justos,
then it saves the city from destruction.
Entonces salva la ciudad de destrucción.
So speaking.
So hablando.
When Yeshua speaks.
Cuando Yeshua habla.
He was trying to save them from destruction.
Él lo estaba tratando de salvar de la destrucción.
So follow the directions that he gives.
So sigue las instrucciones que él da.
Be perfect.
Sea perfecto.
For your Father in heaven is perfect.
Porque tu Padre en el cielo es perfecto.
Is everybody seeing this?
¿Están viendo esto?
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página.
Exodus 19, please.
Éxodo capítulo 19.
19, verse 5 and 6.
19, versículo 5 y 6.
Exodus 19, verse 5 and 6.
Éxodo capítulo 19, versículos 5 y 6.
Got it? Exodus 19, verse 5 and 6. Stand up. Now, if you'll pay careful attention to what I say and keep my covenant, then you will be my own treasure from among all the people, for all the earth is mine. You will be a kingdom of Kohanim for me, a nation set apart. These are the words you are to speak to the people of Israel. Okay? By speaking,
por hablar,
brings a possibility,
trae una posibilidad,
of being a king, an entire nation that are royalty.
De ser una nación completa de realidad.
So when Yeshua said this, as he began to speak,
Yeshua cuando dijo esto, comenzó a hablar,
the Proverbs talks about giving us wisdom.
Los proverbios nos habla de obtener sabiduría.
Then intercession.
Después, intercesión.
And now we lead to a covenant.
Y ahora llegamos a un pacto.
So here, when we start off in Matthew 5,
aquí, como comenzamos en Mateo 5,
we know later on in verse 18 what happens.
Sabemos después en el versículo 18 que sucede.
In 5:18,
en 5:18,
a confirmation of this covenant.
Una confirmación de este pacto.
So here, speaking brings blessings.
Hablando trae bendiciones.
Speaking brings a covenant.
Hablando trae un pacto.
So this is what Yeshua is going to. He sat down and began to speak with them.
Esto es lo que Yeshua comenzó a hacer. Se sentó y comenzó a hablar con ellos.
He was not going to speak about breaking the covenant,
él
which
no
the
iba
church.
A hablar sobre quebrantar el pacto como la iglesia.
Which the church woefully thinks he did.
Que la iglesia. Vocalmente piensa que él hizo.
Because Rav Shaul writes a better covenant.
Porque Rav Shaul escribe sobre un mejor pacto.
When Shaul writes a better covenant,
cuando Shaul, Pablo habla sobre un mejor pacto,
most New Testament people don't look what that means.
La mayoría de los creyentes del Nuevo Testamento no saben lo que significa.
The word better covenant means college level.
La palabra mejor pacto significa a nivel de universidad.
More responsibility.
Más responsabilidad.
Going back here to Exodus 19, more responsibility.
Regresando aquí a Éxodo capítulo 19, más responsabilidad.
Next slide.
La próxima página.
We had some questions.
Hay preguntas.
For those that didn't get their questions in for the certificate.
Aquellos que no entregaron sus preguntas para el certificado.
Okay. Question number one.
Pregunta número uno.
How many sections to the Beatitudes?
¿Cuántas secciones a las bienaventuranzas?
What does the number mean?
¿Qué significa el número?
So how many Beatitudes were there?
¿Cuántas bienaventuranzas?
Shh. Mario. Okay. What does the number nine mean?
Hey. You gave away the answer.
He already said it.
Mario. No.
All right, number two.
Número dos.
What are Jehovah's people destroyed for?
¿Por qué son destruidos el pueblo de Jehová?
Number three.
Número tres.
What does Hosea say is going to happen to your kids?
¿Qué dice Hosea que va a suceder a tus hijos?
Number four.
Número cuatro.
What significance does the law of first reference imply?
¿Qué significado la implica la ley de primera referencia.
All right, so if you want this certificate,
si quiere este el certificado,
anything under a 90 is not going to get one.
Lo que menos de 90 no va a recibir uno.
We want good students.
Queremos buenos estudiantes.
Okay. All right, going on to the next slide.
Para la próxima página.
Back to Matthew 5.
Regresando a Mateo 5.
This might be also on the test.
Esto va a estar en el examen.
Matthew 5, verse 1 and 2.
Can you go back? She doesn't have all the questions.
Question 1. We need somebody asked her the questions again. Question 1. How many sections of the Beatitudes are there?
¿Cuántas secciones de las bienaventuranzas hay?
What does
¿Qué significa
the number
el
mean?
Número. The law of first reference imply. You're welcome. You're welcome.
Yes, Michaela, you have to do your weekly assignments, and then there's going to be a final exam.
Tiene que hacer tus asignaciones semanales y va a haber un examen final
of the whole Matthew 5 study.
De todo el estudio de Mateo 5.
I want this certificate to mean something.
Yo quiero que este certificado signifique algo para ti.
Okay. Everybody got the questions? We can move on?
Yeah.
Okay. Matthew 5, verse 1 and 2 again.
Mateo 5, versículos 1 y 2 de nuevo.
Okay, now we're focusing on verse 2.
Nos estamos ahora enfocando en el versículo 2.
And he began to speak. This is what he taught them.
Comenzó a hablar y esto fue lo que le enseñó.
Okay. We're focusing on the word taught.
Nos estamos enfocando en la palabra enseñó.
The Greek word is didasco.
La palabra griega es didasco.
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 It's like Tabasco, but we got a didasco.
Es como Tabasco, pero es didasco.
Some teachings can burn.
Algunas enseñanzas queman.
Okay.
O pican.
The definition is for didasco is to teach.
El significado para didasco es enseñar.
To hold discourse with others in order to instruct them.
Mantener un discurso con otros para poder instruirlos.
Deliver didactic discourses.
Entregar discursos didácticos.
Okay, that means to adapt your teachings.
Significa adaptar tus enseñanzas.
To try to get a perspective of the people you're teaching.
Para obtener un para poder presentar un perspectivo a la gente que está enseñando.
That's why sometimes new people who sit at my table for lunch.
Por eso que la gente nueva que se sienta a mi mesa para el lunch.
I ask them what they do for a living.
Le pregunto qué hacen en qué trabajan.
It helps to so I can give a didactic discourse to their questions.
Ayuda para darle un discurso didáctico a sus preguntas.
So if somebody is a truck driver,
si alguien maneja troces,
generally their
camiones,
generally their education level is that of high school, possibly college.
Que su nivel de educación es escuela superior, tal vez universidad.
That doesn't mean they're stupid.
No significa que son estúpidos.
That sometimes means you don't use larger vocabulary.
So, eso significa que a veces no usa vocabularios más grandes.
Like today with the students.
Como hoy con los estudiantes.
I asked them what a whitewashed wall was.
Le pregunté que es una pared lavado blanco.
They got stuck on washing.
Ellos se whitewashed.
When Yeshua calls them a bunch of whitewashed walls.
Cuando Yeshua los llama, ¿ah? Sepulcros blancos. No, whitewash. Sí, pero see, we're having the same trouble. Pintura, es una pintura, pero uno lo pinta con trapo. Y sí, blanqueados, pero no es no es pintura blanca, sino es como que tiñe blanco. El blanco tiñe, no pinta.
No.
It's like the paint stains. It doesn't paint. It's more like staining.
Whitewashed wall is when a stone has been weather worn. So you show a picture of a headstone from the 1700s. You can't see the writing anymore because it has been wiped away. Because it ties together with Devarim 30 when you put the Torah on these stones. Oh. Now say that in Spanish. It's the same thing I went through this morning with the 10-year-olds.
Yeah.
you were focusing on whitewashing, yeah. As in.
Well, no, whitewashing, because whitewashing is painting like a whitewashed fence.
But a whitewash in it is a worn away.
Right.
But,
como pintura gastada. Pintura gastada. Pintura gastada, whitewash, ¿no?
Okay. To do this didactic discourse,
para hacer este discurso didáctico,
we have to adapt the words to each person.
Tenemos que adaptar las palabras para cada persona.
So a whitewashed wall.
Una, hold on. I'm trying to get it in Spanish. Un muro encalado.
No.
It says it right there. Encalado. Sí. Un muro encalado.
Okay. So, what it is the stone has been worn away.
Lo que es que la piedra se ha gastado.
So, when you're having a didactic discourse,
cuando tienes un discurso didáctico,
what you're trying to do is adapt it to whom you're speaking to.
Lo que estás tratando de hacer es adaptarlo a quien estás hablando.
Okay. Okay. So, Cal S. N. Spanish La Seconde de Piedra?
Yeah.
I don't know, it's coming from a Spanish person.
Rabbi,
hi, yes.
Is it easy or how difficult it is to do that to an our audience or students in different levels?
When the Lord gives me his messages for Shabbat,
cuando el Señor me da sus mensajes para Shabbat,
a lot of times, everything's not written out.
No todo está escrito.
There's ideas on the page.
Hay ideas en una página.
So, as things are said for the message,
mientras están siendo dichas, habladas las cosas,
depending on who's in the sanctuary,
dependiendo de quién esté en el santuario,
you'll probably hear some different examples.
Tal vez escuches diferentes ejemplos.
So that although you're a certain type of person,
es como decir tú eres una cierta clase de persona.
Or Oscar's a different type of person.
Oscar es un diferente clase de persona.
And then also during Road to Emmaus.
Y también durante el camino de Emmaus.
When people ask questions,
cuando las personas hacen preguntas,
there is an agenda behind the question.
Hay una agenda detrás de la pregunta.
And it generally comes from what they do for a living.
Y normalmente viene de qué ellos hacen en la vida.
Where they've come from.
De a dónde vienen.
Where their walk is.
A donde está su caminar.
So as a teacher, what Yeshua was doing, he had a didactic discourse.
Yeshua como maestro tuvo un discurso didáctico.
You see, he speaks many times about seeds because it was a farming community.
Tú ves que él habla mucho sobre semillas porque era una comunidad de graneros.
He generally, a lot of times he speaks about fish.
Muchas veces él hablaba sobre los pescados.
Because in the north it was a fishing community.
Porque en el norte era una comunidad de pescadores.
So here I have to adapt sometimes to the community that is in front of me.
So aquí a veces tengo que adaptarme a la comunidad que está delante de mí.
But the didactic discourse,
pero el discurso didáctico,
has to contain the doctrine.
Tienes que contener la doctrina.
It has to contain the precepts.
Tiene que contener los preceptos
of Torah.
De Torah.
You can't stray too far away.
No te puedes alejar muy lejos.
But you know, let's say you're talking to somebody who's a truck driver.
Vamos a suponer que estás hablando con alguien que maneja trucks.
You might use driving analogies.
Tal vez uses ejemplos de manejar.
You know, with Dr. Mark, since I have a medical background, I sometimes use that terminology.
Como con el Dr. Mark, como tengo experiencia en el camino médico, a veces uso esa terminología.
For somebody that's been in the serving industry.
Para alguien que ha estado en la industria de servir.
It's like balancing four plates on your arm.
Es como balancear cuatro platos en tu brazo.
Okay? Or somebody who's driven a school bus.
O alguien que ha manejado un autobús de escolar.
You have to try to impart the knowledge where people will be able to understand it.
Tienes que tratar de compartir la sabiduría donde la gente lo pueda
entender. And impart in a didactic discourse doctrine.
Y compartirlo en un discurso didáctico de doctrina.
That's what Matthew 5 is all about.
Y de eso es lo que se trata Mateo 5.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página.
Turn to Deuteronomy 4.
Vamos a Deuteronomio 4.
We're focusing on the word taught.
Nos estamos enfocando en la palabra enseñó.
Deuteronomy 4, verse 5 through 9.
Deuteronomio capítulo 4, versículos 5 al 9. Is doing it again?
No, I know there's words behind here, so I'm trying to... Okay, Deuteronomy 4,
Deuteronomio 4,
verse 5 through 9.
Versículos 5 al
9. We're focusing on the word taught.
Estamos enfocándonos en la palabra enseñó.
Look, I have taught you the laws and rulings just as Jehovah my Elohim ordered me, so that you can behave accordingly in the land where you're going in order to take possession of it. Therefore, observe them and follow them. Then all peoples will see you as having wisdom and understanding. When they hear all these laws, they will say, the great nation is surely wise and understanding people. For what great nation is there that has a God as close to them as Jehovah our Elohim is, whenever we call on him? What great nation is there that has laws and rulings as just as the entire Torah, which I'm setting before you today? Only be careful and watch yourselves diligently as long as you live, so that you won't forget what you saw with your own eyes, so that these things won't vanish from your hearts. Rather, make them known to your children and grandchildren. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, so taught, verse 5,
en versículo 5,
speaks about the laws and the rulings.
Habla de las reglas y las leyes.
So if we understand that,
entendemos eso,
everything Yeshua teaches would not contradict this verse.
Todo lo que enseña Yeshua no va a contradecir con este versículo.
And striving for perfection that we see in verse 48,
y luchando para la perfección que vemos en el versículo 48,
gets you a great nation status.
Te da un estatus de gran nación.
This is something Donald Duck doesn't understand.
Esto es algo que el Pato Donald no entiende.
Okay? If he turns to God, then we can have a great leader.
Si se entrega a Dios, podemos tener un gran líder.
If the wicked witch from Arkansas turns to God,
si la bruja mala de Arkansas se convierte, podemos tener gran líder.
Then we can have a great leader.
Entonces podemos tener un
gran Nobody leader. Is out of God's reach.
Nadie está fuera del alcance de Dios.
Nobody is out of God's reach.
Nadie está fuera del alcance de Dios.
So we pray that whoever he puts there would turn to God. But remember, the reason he's putting one of those people there,
acuérdate que la razón es que él está poniendo una de esas personas ahí,
is because the church, the messianic body, has failed.
Es porque la iglesia, el cuerpo mesiánico, ha fracasado.
Because they don't focus on these teachings.
Porque no se enfocan en estas enseñanzas.
They don't focus on Yeshua.
No se enfocan en Yeshua.
They focus on constantly being forgiven instead of being perfect, for your Father in heaven is perfect.
Se enfocan en constantemente ser perdonados en vez de ser perfectos como su Padre en el cielo es perfecto.
Next slide.
Próxima página.
Proverbs 13, please.
Proverbios capítulo 13, por favor.
Proverbs 13, verse 18.
Proverbios capítulo 13, versículo 18.
This also ties together with verse 3.
Esto también se une con el versículo 3.
Poverty and shame are for him who won't be taught, but he who heeds reproof will be honored. So being taught,
ser enseñado,
if you've refused to be taught,
si te rehúsa ser enseñado,
then poverty and shame will come your way.
Entonces la pobreza y vergüenza vendrá sobre ti.
But understand this in verse 3.
Pero entiendas que en versículo 3.
What does Yeshua say in Matthew 5, verse 3?
Que Yeshua dice en Mateo 5, versículo 3.
Blessed are the poor.
Bienaventurados los pobres.
In spirit.
En espíritu.
For theirs is the kingdom of God.
Porque de ellos es el reino de Dios.
So if you want to be taught.
So si quieres ser enseñado.
Then you gotta understand the laws.
Entonces, tienes que entender las leyes.
You have to strive for perfection.
Tienes que luchar para la perfección.
But if you won't be taught,
pero si no vas a ser enseñado,
if you won't understand reproof,
si no puedes entender, corrección,
then shame is on your doorstep.
Entonces, la vergüenza está a tu puerta.
Next slide.
La próxima página.
Psalm 119, we're going to read Psalm 119.
Salmo 119, vamos a leer.
Verse 97 through 104.
Versículos 97 al 104.
Psalm, Tehillim.
Tehillim, Salmos, capítulo 119.
Verse 97 to 104.
Versículos 97 al 104.
Everybody got it?
Todos lo tienen.
How I love your Torah. I meditate on it all day. I am wiser than my foes because your mitzvot are mine forever. I have more understanding than all my teachers because I meditate on your instruction. I understand more than my elders because I keep your precepts. I keep my feet from every evil way in order to observe your word. I don't turn away from your rulings because you have instructed me. How sweet to my tongue is your promise, truly sweeter than honey in my mouth. For your precepts I gain understanding. This is why I hate every false way. Okay? So here, verse 102,
aquí en el versículo 102,
is our key.
Es nuestra clave.
I don't turn away from your rulings because they have instructed me.
No me aparto de tus reglas porque me han instruido.
So Yeshua is not going to contradict this in his teachings.
So Yeshua no va a contradecir esto en sus enseñanzas.
The rulings are perfect.
Las reglas son perfectas.
They are true.
Son verdaderas.
And he hates a false way.
Y odia un camino falso.
Meditating on God's word each day.
Meditando en las palabras de Dios todos los días.
Is a good thing.
Es algo bueno.
What Torah does,
lo que hace Torah,
is it makes you wiser than everybody else.
Que te hace más sabio que lo demás.
So when somebody says they don't want Torah,
so cuando alguien dice que no quiere
or
Torah,
we're no longer under that, you tell them they're an idiot.
O que ya no estamos bajo Torah, tú le dices que son.
Because that's what Ezra said here in Psalm 119.
Porque eso fue lo que dijo Ezra aquí en Salmo 119.
Okay, and that's what Yeshua is saying.
Eso es lo que está diciendo Yeshua.
You whitewashed wall.
Tú muro encalado.
Going on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Proverbs 4.
Salmos 4.
Proverbs 4, verse 4 and 5.
Proverbios 4, versículo 4 y 5.
Proverbs 4.
Proverbios 4.
Verse 4 and 5. Like I said, we're going to lead up to this. You already got a little part of it with
como,
the other
como dije,
proverb.
Vamos a llegar a esto que recibiste una pequeña parte con el otro proverbio.
Leading up to verse 3.
Que nos va a llegar al versículo 3.
Okay, Matthew 5 next week.
Mateo 5, la semana que
viene. Few more minutes, we're almost done with the review.
Ya casi estamos terminando.
Proverbs 4, verse 4 and 5.
Proverbios 4, versículos 4 y 5.
He too taught me, he said to me, let your heart treasure my words, keep my commands, and live. Gain wisdom, gain insight. Don't forget to turn from the words I am saying. Okay? Keeping the commandments will enable you to live.
Guardando los mandamientos te ayuda a vivir.
So everything Yeshua is going to say in verse 2,
so todo lo que Yeshua va a decir en el versículo 2,
in teaching,
en enseñando,
is going to bring you closer to life and life fullness.
Te va a traer más cerca a la vida y a la vida completa.
That's what people don't understand.
Y eso es lo que la gente no entiende.
But what we're going to learn in this incredible chapter of Matthew 5,
pero lo que vamos a aprender en este capítulo increíble de Mateo
5, is that every word Yeshua chooses
que cada palabra que escoge Yeshua
is extremely powerful.
Es extremadamente poderosa.
Going on to the next slide.
La próxima página.
Jeremiah 9.
Jeremías capítulo 9.
Verse 5.
Versículo 5.
Jeremiah 9.
Jeremías capítulo 9. Versículo
5. Jeremiah 9, Yirmiyahu 9.
Jeremías capítulo 9, versículo 5.
Everyone deceives his neighbor. No one speaks the truth. They have taught their tongues to lie, Hillary. They wear themselves out with sinning. Okay? So that this verse is our society today.
Este versículo es nuestra sociedad hoy.
Teaching children to lie.
Enseñándole a los niños a mentir.
How does the Christian church teach their children to lie?
¿Cómo que la iglesia cristiana le enseña a sus hijos a mentir?
Christmas.
Navidad.
Santa Claus brought you the presents.
Santa Claus te trajo los regalos.
You've taught your child to lie.
Ha enseñado a tus hijos a mentir.
You've taught your child to lie.
Ha enseñado a tus hijos a mentir.
So when a society holds that truth,
so cuando la sociedad holds that truth,
aguanta, se reguinda de esa verdad, then that society will not last very
entonces
long.
Esa sociedad no va a durar.
Because after a while, only one leader raises up.
Porque después de un tiempo, solamente un líder se levanta.
And his name would be like Castro.
Y su nombre será como Castro.
Or Kim Jong-un.
Kim Jong-un.
Whose wife is now missing.
Que su, maybe he shot her with a tank.
When you're a dictator, you do what you want.
Cuando eres dictador, hace lo que quieres.
So here God is saying, teach.
Aquí Dios está diciendo,
what Yeshua is going to teach next is amazing.
Lo que Yeshua va a enseñar próximo es asombrante.
But you got to understand, it cannot contradict what the word taught means.
Pero tienes que acordarte que no puede contradecir con lo que significa la palabra enseñó.
Okay, our last three questions.
Nuestras últimas tres
preguntas. You're taking this for a certificate.
Estás tomando esto para un certificado.
Is what is didactic discourses?
¿Qué son discursos didácticos?
Number two.
Número dos.
Poverty and shame are for who?
La pobreza y vergüenza son para quién?
Poverty and shame are for who?
Pobreza y vergüenza son para quién?
And number three, their tongues are taught what in Yirmiyahu?
Número tres, sus lenguas fueron enseñados ¿qué en Jeremías?
To be a politician.
A ser político.
And that is it for the review.
Y eso es todo para el repaso.
I will now take questions from...
Ahora tomaré preguntas de...
I think Michaela fell off. Any questions from WebEx?
Hay preguntas en WebEx.
Diana, you're good? Joanne, you're good? Okay. Diana, you have a question? I see the thumbs up. There's the thumb from the side there. All right. And... Okay, we got
no
cameras here.
For me.
And any questions in the room? Any questions in the room?
Hay preguntas aquí en la puerta de la ciudad.
Okay, no hands up. And next week we will begin verse 3. And we'll, like I said, begin.
Y la próxima semana comenzaremos con el versículo 3, como dije. Comenzaremos.
Like I said, I think I'm up to 33 slides and I only got to the first word.
Tengo 33 páginas y solamente ha llegado a la primera palabra.
All right, now if you missed anything, please go back in the other parts on the web.
Ahora si te faltó algo, regresa a las otras partes en el internet.
All right, let's close in prayer.
Vamos a cerrar con oración.
Thank you, Lord, for your blessings today. Thank you, Lord, for this beautiful review. Your words are so amazing, Yeshua. Let us draw closer to your words so that when we get up there, our lives will be found in your book. And when we are weighed on our actions, they will be actions that are pleasing to you and following in your footsteps. In your name, Yeshua. Amen.
Shalom. This is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman. I would personally like to thank you for tuning in to The Remnant's Call each and every week. You can listen to the full message on our website, bethgoyim.org. If you have drawn closer to the King of Kings, learned more about Him today, we are blessed. If you are blessed by these messages, please consider a donation to our ministry. You can go to our website, bethgoyim.org. That's bethgoyim.org, and click on the donate button. You do not have to have a PayPal account to donate. All you need is a debit card. Once again, thank you very much for listening to The Remnant's Call.
If you have not taken your first steps to be born again, just ask God's help. Remember, it's His loving grace that has come to find you. No one is worthy or able to reach God, but God can reach us, and He's reaching out to you now. Just open your heart and let Him in. His arms are open, and the blessing of salvation and eternal life are waiting for you. Don't let it wait any longer.
Shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift His face and shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you His shalom.
Shalom. My name is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman, and I invite you to come to visit our congregation. If you are in the tri-state area, come out and visit with us on Shabbat. We are a congregation of Jews and Gentiles living as one in the Messiah Yeshua. BGMC is a place of true worship. The focus never wanders from the Hebraic roots of our faith. Beth Goyim is rooted in the Word of God from Bereshit through to the Book of Revelation. Messiah's strong words against man-made tradition are carefully recorded in Matthew 7.
That is the reason we only follow the straight-up instructions found in Scripture, truly the way, the truth, and the life. If you're looking for a deeper walk with Adonai, come out for our Tuesday evening Bible study called Messianic Torah Time. Come, spend the day with us on any Shabbat. We start at 11 a.m. with the sound of the ancient Hebrew shofar. Next, we offer our King praise and worship in English, Hebrew, and Spanish. After worship, we review the headlines in the previous week's news from around the globe, especially news from the Holy Land Israel. We don't just list the news headlines as current events, but we comb through the scriptures, searching for clues to understand what they mean and then to help pinpoint prophetically our current position on Adonai's clock. After digesting all that modern information, we leave the world behind as we journey with our Adonai deep into his eternal word, not with just one or two scriptures, but usually seven or more scriptures. The spiritual nourishment and the richness of his kingdom become accessible to the ones who share this special time and seek them out. The day does not end there. Because Shabbat is so special to him, there is always so much more that our King desires to share. So instead of separating and leaving, we stay together as a family for potluck lunch and an afternoon study of our King's Word. We close the Shabbat together with the reading of the new week's parasha. That's the Torah portion. Even after those blessings, many of us just can't get enough. So the members bring prepared homemade foods to share while we all enjoy an uplifting movie together. If all that information is not quite enough, you can check out our website where you will find over 200 video teachings and biblical holy day studies. Under Messianic Torah Time, the Hebrew Roots button, you'll discover free studies on many, many different topics, including PowerPoint slide presentations. If Beth Goyim sounds like a place you'd love to visit, but you live outside the tri-state area, there is still a way to connect with us. We stream live on the internet on Tuesday, Thursday, and Shabbat. The website is www.bethgoyim.org. That's BethGoyim.org. Our phone number is 973-338-7800 or 978-2-YESHUA. That's 978, the number 2, Yeshua. Shalom.